This is the Splach Transformer electric scooter, mini bike, whatever. I'm Ben Schmanke from AuthenTech, and let's check it out.
Oh, it just looks so cool.
Let's see how fast she goes. Whee! Oh my word!
It says 24 kilometers an hour.
15 miles per hour. What do you have to say for yourself?
You know, I've seen better, but it's still fun. I mean, it looks really cool. Kind of stealthy design. Front and rear suspension, which is nice. I think you can buy an optional accessory to widen these, and that would be highly recommended. Dual brakes, which is nice. Only single motor, rear and the hub, which is okay. But honestly, for off-roading, you really want dual. All right, we've got a little off-roading playground. Let's do some all-terrain riding and see how it goes. Now, the Transformer is great for a little off-roading and stuff, but even a little hill climbing like this, the torque just isn't there. You only got single motor and it's not the most powerful. So first, let's try the Transformer up the hill, see if it has enough power to take me up. I hope it does. But then show you guys a little comparison of a sweet $3,000 true off-roading scooter from Nan Robot. Yeah, so not great, but okay. Nan Robot LS7 Plus, a little bit over $3,000. Ooh, she's got the power and suspension. Watch this. Now, I'm pretty sure there's a few models right now that can go maybe a little bit faster, or like they said mine was pre-release firmware or something like that. So mine can't even hit that max speeds. Mine 15, a little slow. I wish 20 or a little bit faster and more torque would be great to see. All right, this is my buddy Nick. He's ridden a lot of my electric scooters. Take it for a little test spin and let me know your thoughts.
All right, let's go.
All right, send it.
She definitely rides a lot different. Your weight distribution towards the back, and you mentioned it like hurts your feet. When you're on a bicycle, your butt's kind of absorbing the weight, but when you're just standing here, it does hurt those feet.
I think suspension's probably my favorite part. I wish it was more powerful motor, actually dual motor, and maybe bigger wheels. And then this thing would be so much fun to rip off-road. All right, now one of my sayings is never scoot faster than you can run. This thing top speed, at least my model, is 15 miles per hour. It's a little sluggish. Let's see if Nick here can beat me. Ready, set, go! Range, I can win, but top speed 15. I wish it was a bit faster.
If your feet are hurting you, have no fear. We have the solution. It's a little crotch rocket.
Woo! I mean, it's a fun ride. It's unique and stuff with this positioning. However, I think these things are, what, over $1,000? If it was like, I don't know, 600 or 700, yeah, maybe. But those longer commutes, my feet are aching after 5 or 10 minutes, which those wider pegs will help. I mean, I guess you can sit if you really want long range, but over $1,000, it's a little steep. So, concluding thoughts on the Transformer. It is fun, it's a unique riding position, it's kind of cool, that's a great wheeling machine with your weight in the back. If they could get that price point lower to maybe 500 or 700, I think that'd be really sweet. It's a lot more incentive to go with something unique and fun, but it's a little bit underpowered. All right, now thanks for watching, guys. All links and everything down below, and I'll see you in the next one.